Hello and welcome back to the Proactive Investors New York studio. I'm Christine Corrado. With me in studio today is Dr. Raj Mehra from Seelos Therapeutics. He's the CEO. On Skype, I have Dr. Jeffrey Kordower from the Alavi and Solomon Jessimer Professor of Neurological Sciences at Rush University Medical Center, and then also Dr. Tim Whitaker, Head of R&D for Seelos. Great to have you all on today.
Thank you, Christine, for having us.
So, Dr. Mehra, I'm going to start with you. You had announced today the acquisition of an exclusive license of gene therapy program for Parkinson's disease from Duke University Medical Center. Can you just describe this program for our viewers?
Thank you, Christine. So this is an exciting program for Seelos to have. First of all, our focus continues to remain as alpha-synuclein as a therapeutic target because we do believe that targeting alpha-synuclein aggregates will lead to potentially curative therapies for this program. So SLS-004 is the term that we are providing to this program that we just acquired. This is an all-in-one lentiviral vector that will methylate the intron 1 of SNCA gene. SNCA gene is the one that encodes the alpha-synuclein protein. So this program is based on the CRISPR-Cas9 system. And what has been demonstrated using this system, which is a one-shot deal, is when it's given to the dopaminergic neurons derived from the stem cells of a PD or Parkinson's disease patients, that it actually decreases the expression of the alpha-synuclein protein and literally in these cell cultures have shown that the Parkinsonism disappears. So that's the program that we think is worth pursuing for Parkinson's disease, and it can also be applicable to other diseases such as dementia with Lewy bodies or multiple system atrophy, because those diseases also have alpha-synuclein aggregates responsible for the pathology of those diseases.
Dr. Kordower, I'll now turn to you. In your opinion, how does this newly acquired program benefit Parkinson's patients?
First of all, there's a consensus that alpha-synuclein is the number one target to go after in patients with Parkinson's disease, dementia with Lewy bodies, and multiple system atrophy. I think it's the fact that it's a gene therapy approach in which all you got to do is apply it one time. That has great advantages for patients with Parkinson's disease as well. Just one thing, this also approach is not just for the dopaminergic neurons that control, that are responsible for the cardinal symptoms of Parkinson's disease, but alpha-synuclein is pathological in many brain regions in these diseases, and it should also help other aspects of Parkinson's disease, especially the major unmet needs being dementia and falling and changes in gait.
Well, we know that Seelos already has SLS-007, the peptide inhibitor. How is this different? How is SLS-004 different from what Seelos has currently?
Well, the other 007 is mainly works by preventing the aggregation of alpha-synuclein into a toxic form. This is more reducing the levels of alpha-synuclein. So the mechanism is slightly different, but the end result hopefully will be the same, that the toxic species of alpha-synuclein will not be formed in patients with Parkinson's disease.
So Dr. Whitaker, what's your view on today's developments?
Well, this slide that Dr. Kordower has beautifully presented in one of his papers summarizes the time points in this molecular pathologic cascade of alpha-synuclein. And there's points within that cascade that can be interrupted as therapeutic targets. So you see point number one, this is the SNCA gene therapy program that we're talking about today, engineered to target the gene that regulates alpha-synuclein production and to reduce the production. Now our 007 program that we previously mentioned is the peptide-based program that's engineered to bind alpha-synuclein and to prevent the aggregation. Also number three you see here, and all of these are intracellular approaches, this is to enhance the degradation of alpha-synuclein by stimulating autophagy or lysosomal pathways. And these are two pathways within the cells that degrade proteins and other substances, and also remove the debris. Our 005 program, one of its mechanisms is to enhance degradation. At this point, we're actually moving that forward as orphan diseases. But you see, we actually, 1, 2, and 3, we have different assets that target each of those mechanisms. And as it points out, we're very serious about this alpha-synuclein target, and we're very excited to move all these programs forward.
Thanks very much, Dr. Whitaker. And Dr. Mehra, just turning back to you, I mean, this all seems like very exciting developments for the company and for investors. So what are kind of the next steps for SLS-004?
So the next steps for us is to move this innovative CRISPR-Cas9-based system into in vivo Parkinson's animal models. Under the collaboration with Dr. Ornit Chiba-Falik, she's a professor of neurology at Duke University Medical Center, in conjunction with Dr. Boris Cantor, he's the head of their viral vector core at Duke. Both of them were the co-inventors of the program that we just acquired. So in collaboration with them, as well as with Dr. Kordower, we will move these programs forward. And what the Duke University researchers have demonstrated that the guide RNAs can modulate the alpha-synuclein expression to a different degree as desired. So based on different patients will have a different amount of alpha-synuclein dysregulation, we can precisely create a medication for different patients. So that's the program we'll move forward, and we'll show you more preclinical studies in obtaining the efficacy and safety before we take it into human clinical trials.
Definitely excited to see how studies progress. Dr. Mehra, Dr. Kordower, and Dr. Whitaker, thank you all so much for your time today.
Great, and we'll love to come back and give you then updates. Thank you, Christine.